Hello friends, welcome to this session. In this session, we are going to learn about synthesis of different drugs from the antihistaminic class. Very first of all, we will learn about the synthesis of diphenhydramine hydrochloride, which is a classical H1 antagonist, that is from the first class of alkyl amino ether analogs. Very first of all, before going to synthesize this diphenhydramine, we must be familiar with the structure of the diphenhydramine hydrochloride. So it is a class of alkyl amino ether. So if we able to write down the structure of the diphenhydramine hydrochloride, we can easily apply the retrosynthesis approach here, and we can easily find out that we can make a synthesis of two parts, that is this one part and this one part. So the starting material for the synthesis of diphenhydramine hydrochloride, we can take diphenyl methane, which we should treat with the bromine in presence of potassium carbonate, so that the acidic hydrogen get replaced and the diphenyl bromomethane is to be obtained. Further, we can take an alkyl side chain, that is an NN dimethyl ethanol amine side chain. So by treating this NN dimethyl ethanol amine analog with this diphenyl bromomethane, there is a dehalogenation takes place, that is the removal of HBr takes place, and here we can get a diphenhydramine, which is further when treated with a dilute hydrochloric acid, that will give formation of diphenhydramine hydrochloride. So this way we can synthesize the diphenhydramine hydrochloride. The next synthesis, trifluoridine hydrochloride, which is again a H1 antagonist. Here also we require to know about the structure. So we can take a starting material here, 4-methyl acetophenol, formaldehyde and pyrrolidine. And by performing the managed condensation, we can obtain this intermediate, which will further treated with the magnesium pyridine magnesium bromide, that is a 2-pyridyl magnesium bromide, which is a Grignard reagent, and that will give us intermediate after dehydration in presence of concentrated H2S4, which will be converted to the trifluoridine, and which is further with treating with dilute hydrochloric acid, that will give the salt, that is the trifluoridine hydrochloride salt. So this way we can synthesize a second drug, that is trifluoridine hydrochloride H1 antagonist. Next, classical antihistamine from the phenothiazine class, that is the promethazine hydrochloride. So here also we require to know about the structure of the compound, so that we can separately synthesize the alkyl side chain and a promethazine tricyclic heterocyclic nucleus. So here a starting material phenothiazine is treated with 2N dimethyl amino 1 chloropropane. So this is a 1, 2, 3, this is a chloropropane, and at the second position there is a NN dimethyl, that is N dimethyl amino group is to be substituted on this 1 chloropropane at second position, and these two constituents we can react together in presence of strong base like sodium hydroxide, so that the hydrogen of this phenothiazine ring, that is get replaced with this alkyl side chain. So by this way we can obtain promethazine, which is further after treatment with the dilute hydrochloric acid, that will give a formation of promethazine hydrochloride. Next drug is cimetidine, which is an H2 antagonist. Here we can take a starting material ethyl 5-methylimidazole carboxylate in presence of lithium aluminum hydride. We can get the remove these ester moieties, and that is to be converted to alcoholic substitution on this imidazole moiety. So which is further treated with this mercaptoethylamine, that is 2-mercaptoethylamine group, and after dehydration that will give us the intermediate, which is further treated with the diphenyl N-cyanodiol immunocarbonate. By this way, we can obtain the compound, and which is further after substitution with this methylamine group, that will give formation of cimetic acid. Next, synthesis of chlorpheniramine. Here we can take a starting material, that is paracloro-cyanobenzene, which is treated with a 2-chloropyridine in presence of strong base like sodium hydroxide. So we can get an intermediate compound, which is further in presence of strong base like sodium hydroxide, treated with NN dimethyl 2-chloroethanamine. So which will give us an intermediate compound, which is further in presence of concentrated ester support, that will remove this cyano group and we will get a chlorpheniramine compound. Further treatment with a dilute hydrochloric acid, that will give chlorpheniramine hydrochloride. Now the different questions for the assignment on the classic this antihistamine chapter. Here we can write different questions, like we can solve the different short answer questions. First, discuss biosynthesis and metabolism of histamine. What are antihistamines? Classify antihistamines. Discuss structural activity relationship of ethanol amine class of antihistamine. What are classical antihistamines? Discuss SAR of the propylamine derivative. Next question is, define and classify antihistamine. Discuss SAR of H2 antagonist. Write a short note on proton pump inhibitor and write synthesis of drugs like trifluridine, trifenhydramine, chlorpheniramine, etc. Now, different MCQs on antihistamines. Here, we'll go to attend different MCQs on these antihistamines. Look at here, what is the correct IPAC name of the following drug? If you look at here, this is an alkyl amino ether analog, and so we can, if we look at the structure and different options, here 2-diphenylmethoxy, so this is 2-diphenylmethoxy group, and NN dimethyl ethanamine, so this is NN dimethyl, this is ethanamine. So if we look at this option, so this is the correct option by looking the structure. The remaining options are incorrect, because this is not a propanamine, that is here no propanamine is present. This is a diethyl, so here NN dimethyl, so it is also incorrect option. And here 3-diphenylmethyl, so here no 3-diphenyl is possible. So only the option number 1 is correct and remaining option are incorrect. Next question, which of the following drug is antihistamine? Promethazine, chlorpromazine, chloroquine, carmosine. Carmosine is an antineoplastic agent, chloroquine is antimalarial, chloropromazine is antipsychotic. So the correct option here is a promethazine, which is a phenothiazine analog. Next question, which of the following amine is an atropod? Bradykinin, lipotriene, histamine, prostaglandin. We all have learned that histamine is an amine which is to be synthesized from L-histidine. So the correct option here is a histidine. Next question, which of the following is not second generation antihistamines? So sitravirine, lauretidine, pyrazinamide, all these are the second generation antihistamines. The cyclazine, which is a first generation drug, it is a not correct option. So the correct option for this question is, that is cyclazine, which is not second generation antihistamine. Next question is, which of the following action is caused by H1 receptors? Which is not caused by H1 receptor. So gastric acid secretion is to be blocked by H2 receptors antagonists. So that means the gastric acid secretion activity is only caused by H2 receptors. So this is not caused by H1 receptors. The correct option here is again gastric acid secretions. Hexophenidine is a metabolite product of terphenidine, lauretidine, sitravirine, and other. So the terphenidine, which is further undergoes metabolism, and after metabolism it will give the hexophenidine. The commonest side effect of the antihistamines is euphoria, tinnitus, sedation, all of the above. Here the correct option is sedation. Histamine is a biosynthesized from which amino acid? Alanine, tyrosine, histidine, glycine. The correct option here is yes, histidine. Which of the following is not a proton pump inhibitor? Lansoprazole, omeprazole, bromethazine and pentaprazole. All other series is a proton pump inhibitor. Here the phenothiazine is the only option which is not a proton pump inhibitor, which is a classical antihistamine. Now the last question, that is identify the structure from the given structure we have to identify. If you look at here, this is 1, 2, 3, this is a propanamine analog. So the class is, it is in a propanamine class, and if you look at the structure, so this is a diphenhydramine, bromethazine, chlorpheniramine. So here is a chlorine phenyl. The correct option here is a chlorpheniramine. So thank you. So this way we have finished the second chapter, that is antihistamine. Thank you.